Anyone with a yard hates having to mow. And you probably wish that something like this was reality. Well, it is. This is Robomow, an electric bagless mower that cuts your lawn for you. Robomow has several different models available. All are about the size of your traditional lawnmower and range from $1,000 to about $2,100. It requires a little bit of setup time. Oh, a lot, in fact. You'll need to run a perimeter wire that the mower senses around your yard, as well as around any obstacles like non-raised flower beds. So you can expect to be on your hands and knees for several hours. Stake the base station into the ground and run power, and you're ready to go. Robomow has an app that lets you program mow cycles and manage zones that you want mowed. The Robomow will edge your perimeter and then start cutting randomly across a yard until it's done. So, if you're the type of person that likes those nice, clean, defined lines on your lawn, this is probably not for you. If the mower hits an obstacle, it'll stop, change direction, and keep on mowing. And when it runs out of juice, the mower heads home to recharge before going back out to finish the job. Now, Robomow claims the unit can run for about 45 minutes before it needs to recharge, but when it does, it charges for upwards of about 2 hours, so not really an even trade. The unit has dual mulching blades, so there's no bag. However, my lawn had some visible clippings, but the blade height can be adjusted to fix that. You'll also want to make sure you set it high enough so that you don't give your sprinkler heads a shave, which it did to my one non-recessed sprinkler. Another thing is that the power box for the base needs to be mounted inside a garage because it's not meant to be left outside. So if you're like me and you don't have a garage, you'd have to mount it inside your house and then run the cord outside. Also, I have bricks on the edge of my lawn, and the mower can't drive over these on its own, so I had to carry it manually from one side of the lawn to the other. You can also move the mower via the app or an optional remote control, but the unit moves just as slowly as when it's mowing, so unless you have a bad shoulder, you're probably better off just carrying it around. The mower really only works best with lawns that are flush to the driveway and don't have a fence between the front and back yards. That's the only way the mower can run its entire schedule without you having to move it manually from one zone to the other. Another thing is that the mower doesn't just mow your lawn once a week and then sit in the base station the rest of the time. It's basically always running a schedule throughout the week, so you always have that look of a freshly cut lawn. It doesn't emit fumes, and it's pretty quiet compared to a gas mower, but it may still require a lot of interaction with you just to get it around the yard. So it's really up to you if you want to push a mower around for an hour a week, or just let the Robomow do its thing while you do yours.